Hello friends, we'll be discussing the concept of cardinal utility analysis now. Now, we have already understood cardinal utility means what that means. The measurement or rather measurement of a specific satisfaction, whatever satisfaction you have had, if we can measure that in definite numbers, that is the approach that is known as cardinal utility. Now, let us understand more details about this approach itself by analyzing certain things. Now, cardinal utility analysis is based on certain assumptions. Here, we are speaking about certain assumptions, hence we are talking about this. These are as follows. First, rational consumer. The first assumption is that we assume that all the consumers under this category or rather under this approach are rational consumers. No one is irrational, no one is insane. So everyone is sane mind and has the same kind of logic. That is the assumption. Consumer is believed to be rational and his aim is to maximize utility subject to the income constraint. Now, with this assumption, we also assume that the aim of the customer is to maximize his utility with the income constraint. So whatever money he has, within that, he has to have maximum satisfaction, maximum utility is his approach, is his need. That is the thing. This is the first assumption, basically. Second is utility is cardinally measurable. Second assumption is that satisfaction is itself in terms is measured by numbers. It can be measured by numbers. This is what we are assuming. The utility is measurable and quantifiable in definite numbers. This is our assumption. For example, a consumer can say that he obtains utility equal to 20 utils from the consumption of good X and 10 utils from the consumption of good Y. Now, if you have mango, you have this much level of satisfaction, like 20 units of satisfaction. If you have an orange, you have 10 units of satisfaction. This assumption is done by us. We don't have any kind of mathematical law related to how did you derive 20 satisfactions or 20 units of satisfaction and 10 units for satisfaction for every product. That depends on how we approach or rather how is our approach towards that specific thing. So cardinal utility, we have assumed this thing. Hence, these are certain assumptions that you need to take into mind. Now, the next part refers to independent utilities. The next thing that we're talking or rather we are going to talk about is the independent utilities here. According to this school of thought, utility which a consumer derives from the consumption of good is completely dependent upon the quantity of that commodity alone. So whatever commodity you must have had, whatever quantity you must have had of that commodity depends or rather gives out the other factors, that is how much satisfaction you must have had there. It implies that the utility which a consumer gets from one commodity is independent of the consumption of other commodities. So if mango is giving me this kind of utility, not necessary that orange will give me the same kind of utility. It depends on what kind of fruit, what kind of commodity it is. Hence, there is an independent commodity approach or rather independent commodity satisfaction. If Mercedes is giving you certain satisfaction, Range Rover or Lamborghini will giving you different or rather it will give you certain different level of consumption or rather different level of satisfaction. That depends on the consumer as well. Addictive or rather additive utility. The utility derived from the consumption of each commodity can be added to arrive at a total utility derived by the consumer by consuming all the products purchased with his limited income. So if he has limited income, whatever items he has purchased, if he consumes one by one, all the satisfaction that he has gained from consumption of all those units can be added together and that can be taken into consideration. So, constant marginal utility of money. It is assumed that the change in consumer's income do not lead to the change in marginal utility of money for him. The change in income doesn't necessarily change the marginal income utility of that specific money. That is what they are assuming again. In other words, marginal utility of money does not vary with the amount of money an individual holds. So if I'm holding 10,000 rupees or if I'm holding 1,000 rupees, if that amount or if that good is able to be purchased within any of these money's value is still the same. I am going to purchase cigarette or rather if I have 10,000 rupees with me now, right now, if I have 10,000 with me, a pack of cigarette costs around 300 or 400 bucks. So even if I have 10,000, even if I have 1,000, I'm able to purchase that specific box of cigarette. Hence, the marginal utility of money holds no value here. The next part is diminishing marginal utility. It is believed that the marginal utility gained by the consumer from additional units of commodity diminishes as the quantity of consumption for the commodity increases. So, if I'm having one glass of water when I'm very thirsty, that will have higher satisfaction. The next glass, the satisfaction will go a little lower. Now the next glass, again lower. This thing that is going down. So basically, if I have to explain it to you, my satisfaction on a graph will be like, it will be going up like this when the first glass happens. Then when the second glass happens, it will go a little down. Then when the next glass happens, then it will go again down. Then when the next glass happens, it will go again down. And when eventually after a lot of glasses, it will continuously come down. Now, this thing is known as law of diminishing marginal utility. There are certain exceptions for this specific law as well, which we'll be studying in the later part. But this is all what we need to understand when we have to understand the concept, or rather the specifications related to the approach of cardinal utility analysis. So this is how the assumptions are made, and based on this assumption, or rather all these assumptions, cardinal utility approach has been formed or derived. So this is all what we have to discuss when it comes to cardinal utility analysis. Thank you.